We don't see all that's going on around us. But if we'll listen, we'll hear the sound. If we'll listen, we'll hear the call. We'll gather around. It's for one and for all. And he'll call us and we'll come into his presence and the worship and the praise will begin. Because there's a secret place. There's a hiding place. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runneth into it and is safe. And that's where we come in. We hear the sound. We hear the call. Gather around, one and all. Come in. Let the worship begin. And praise steals the enemy and the avenger. The joy of the Lord is our strength. And we have victory in the presence of our God. Can you say that out loud? We have victory in the presence of our God. Say it again. We have victory in the presence of our God. Glory, glory, glory. I always want to be sensitive to that sound. Out on the battlefield, the bugler just needs to sound a sound. Those who have had the training know what that means. It'll be a call to this. It'll be a call to that. The unlearned and the untrained won't understand it. It might sound pretty, nice musical notes, but it has distinction to the trained ear. And the Lord wants us to hear with a trained ear. Hear the sound, hear the sound, hear the sound, hear the call. Hear the sound. Gather round. Gather round, one and all. My sheep know my voice. Glory, glory, glory. Well, that mother goose just makes a sound, and those little goslings are right there. She sees a hawk flying above. They don't see it. She does. Well, she sees they're getting a little bit too close to the shore, and there's a fox there. And she just makes a sound. You might be standing nearby, and you hear the same sound. And watch. They go quick. It meant something to them. That mother duck, just a little quack. To you, it's just a quack. But they go rushing. And then if you look around, there's something rustling in the brush on the shore. And they were getting a little too close to the shore. They didn't see it. That's why we walk by faith, not by sight. Don't wait until you see it. Listen for the sound. We'll avoid some things if we'll listen for the sound. Glory, glory, glory. Hear the sound, hear the sound, hear the sound, hear the call. Hear the sound, hear the sound. Gather round, one and all. Isn't that what those little baby ducks do? They heard the sound, they gathered around. And it was for all of them. She wasn't just calling one, she was calling all of them. It's all for all of them. I want to be sensitive to his sound. I want to be sensitive to his sound. I never want to be dull of hearing. Glory, glory, glory. Can you say amen, somebody? Isn't it good we have a Father that loves us? My sheep know my voice. Let's just listen and respond. He cares for you how my Father doth care for you. If you're not little flock, it's your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Casting all your care upon him because he careth for you. how my Father doth care for us. So we're to grow and to listen. We're to feed upon His word and then be doers thereof. And then the Spirit of God will bring the things of the word unto your heart and even into the remembrance of your mind. Stir up your pure minds by way of remembrance. You have something to do with that, where you put your mind. You have something to do with that, where you put your mind. I'll keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on me. You have something to do with that. Stir up your pure minds by way of remembrance. What you hear. And as we hear again and again and feed upon the precious word of the Lord, the Spirit of God bears witness and confirms. On this earth, the Holy Ghost confirms and performs the word. The Holy Ghost on this earth performs the word of God. As we're doers of the word and not hearers only. Say it out loud, the word puts me over. As I do the word, the Holy Ghost performs, confirms, he hastens his word for me to perform it. As I believe it, as I do it, as I hear it, as I pursue it, the Holy Ghost confirms his word for me. Thank God for it. Thank God for it. Amen. You know, the orchestra, before the symphony begins, tuning up. It doesn't sound all that wonderful while they're all tuning up. But then when the conductor is there and he raises that baton, that music turns sweet. The Lord Jesus is our conductor. And he wants the sound to be sweet. And let's stay until it's complete. I don't know. I used to play in those symphonies. I used to play those in the orchestras. And some songs are longer than other songs. And you just stay till it's finished. You're following the conductor. And he wants the sound to be sweet. Well, there's different times. Sometimes you're soft, sometimes you're loud. Sometimes the timpani plays. Sometimes he's just on a snare with the brushes. But it all has a purpose. The sound has a purpose. The sound has a purpose. Hear the sound. There's a purpose. There's a sound that comes from heaven that has a purpose. Sometimes in certain businesses, sometimes stores, sometimes if you're on a ship, before they give an announcement, they make a sound to get attention. Well, if you're not acclimated to that, you might not know what that sound is for. Well, the crew of the ship, they're trained to hear another sound that passengers don't even need to respond to. That's just for the crew. But the sound has a purpose. And when you're trained, you know what the purpose is. To the unlearned, they don't know what that's for. The orchestra's tuning up. The unlearned, that's just a mess. They've got a purpose. They're tuning up before the symphony begins. That sound before the announcement begins. Even that's got a purpose. God has a purpose with his sound. Let's be trained. The training of our ear. Then we know how to respond when we hear. Did you listen to that? The training of our ear. Then we know how to respond when we hear. I want to hear on the inside, then know what to do. There's a sound. There's a sound, there's a call. Hear the sound. Gather around. One and all. Lord, drain my ear to hear. I'm open to you. Lord, drain my ear to hear. So when I hear, I know what to do. Lord, drain my ear to hear. I want to hear from you. Lord, train my ear to hear. So when I hear, I know what to do. Can somebody say amen? Say it out loud. Lord, train my ear to hear. I want to hear from you. Lord, train my ear to hear. So when I hear, I'll know what to do. He wants to lead us by his voice. He wants to lead us. It'll always be in line with his word, but as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they're the children of God. Is that what the Bible says? He wants to lead us by his Spirit. It'll always be in line with his word, and we better understand and recognize the voice of the Spirit when we know his word. That way we'll know, because it's always in line. If it's not in line with his word, we know we didn't hear him. But he wants to lead us by his Spirit, just like that mother duck does the ducklings, just like that mother goose does the goslings. Quack. Those little ducks know what to do. He wants to lead us by a little nudge, and we know what to do. And we don't be moved by what you see. There's some things out there you don't see. If you wait until you see it, you may be waited too long. Just listen for that voice. We'll avoid some things. Now, we'll see some things. We'll go through some things. Peter walked on the water a little bit. He could have walked the whole way. That's all during the storm. He didn't avoid the storm, but Jesus is just walking on the water, and Peter could have too. Sometimes the storms come, and they don't bring you any alarm, because you know in advance you're not going to have any harm. Now, did you hear that? Even when the storm comes, you don't have any alarm, because you already know in advance you'll not have any harm. Did you hear that? Even when the storm comes, you don't have any alarm, because you know in advance you won't have any harm. But other things we'll avoid, because we hear. We'll avoid. Just a little quack. Didn't see the enemy, but they avoided it because of the training of the ear. They avoided the trouble. And we will too, because of what we hear. Can you say amen? How many of you believe God wants to lead you? Some things you'll avoid. Just follow the leading. Glory, glory, glory. Amen. Well, I'm glad I came today. That's good. That encourages me. Does it encourage you? Thank you, Lord Jesus. Well, I don't understand that. Well, that's good. You don't need to. Some things you should understand, but you don't understand at all. God does. I don't understand it. Well, I don't have to. I don't know why I'm doing that. I don't know why I do a lot of things I do. I don't know what I'm going to do next. Right now, standing here, right here, I don't know what I'm going to do next. I didn't know I was going to do what I already did. Glory. I'm endeavoring to follow the sound. That's what I'm endeavoring to do. I live my life that way. If we would follow, there's sometimes that you'd be driving in your car and you'd take an exit you didn't intend to exit. There's a man that was getting ready to leave a motel. His wife was packing the luggage and he's taking it to the car. And he heard on the inside, "Stay right here 15 minutes. He paused And then he thought, that didn't make any sense. What for? 15 minutes. So he goes back in and gets another bag that's being packed, leaving the motel that morning. And he hears it again. Stay right here 15 minutes. He paused while he's putting the luggage in the back of the car or wagon, whatever it was. And he thought to himself, that doesn't make any sense. Stay right here 15 minutes. What difference does 15 minutes make? So he goes back in and gets the last of the luggage. They pack the car and they head out. It's not too far down the interstate. They're involved in an accident. Multi-car collision. Multi-car collision. And it puts him in the hospital. And his wife died. While he's in the hospital, he's remembering he heard that voice. Stay right here 15 minutes. Now he's got to deal with the condemnation because his wife died. And the Lord doesn't want him to live the rest of his life under a cloud of condemnation. But the Lord was trying to protect him. Well, just repent and learn and go on. And condemnation is never God's will. But things sometimes happen in people's lives, and we don't always know that they hurt on the inside or the Lord was trying to protect them, but they just didn't hear it, didn't recognize it, or just didn't do it. Stay right here 15 minutes. Take that exit. Now, don't get weird and start doing a lot of weird things because the head and the heart are different. I was walking out of the radio station one day. Somebody saw me walking out of the radio station. Brother Tony, you got a word from the Lord for me? Now, if I wasn't as mature as I was, I could have given her anything. Just out of my head. Yeah, the Lord says go to Africa. There's many voices out there. Learn to hear. Train your ear. Don't follow the wrong one. There's a difference between your head and your heart. Don't follow the wrong one. And then don't follow every voice that's out there. Because some people, they'll yield to their own flesh, their own head, and even some of them to the devil. And the devil will even say, thus saith the Lord. So listen and train your ear and listen. Now, whose voice are you going to hear? Make sure it's in line with his word. And then some things develop as you grow. Make sure it's in line with his word. And as you do and mature, then you're more sure. And you know, Paul said in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, he said, despise not prophesying. I think I've been to that church. The reason that he said that is because they were doing a lot of prophesying. And I think I've been to that church. And the reason that he's exhorting them not to despise it is because they've had a lot of prophecy that didn't come to pass. And they've got to the place where they're just beginning to despise it. Because this is junk. And again, I think I've been to that church. But he said, don't despise it. He said, prove it. Did he say that? Prove all things, hold fast to that which is good. So he's saying, I know not all of it's good. Don't despise it. Prove it. And as you do, you'll train yourself and then you'll know and you'll discern what voice to hear. Because as you do, stay steady on course with his word, follow him, and you'll train your ear. Amen. Prove it. Prove it. And then hold fast to that which is good. But that man had a voice on the inside. and obeying that voice? Well, he should. He would have avoided tragedy. But now go your way, because all of us miss it on occasion, sometimes. Go your way without any condemnation, and just grow in God and cast your care upon the Lord, for the Lord says, that's mine. That's mine. I don't want you to carry that. That's mine. Can you say amen, somebody? Amen. Amen. I want to hear him. Riding down the road, take that exit. Realize you just avoided an accident down the road. Some people might do some weird things. Why are you taking that exit? Well, I heard a voice. Uh-huh. Yogi Berra said, we may be lost, but we're making good time. One reason is we took that exit. Well, prove it. That didn't work. No, it didn't. I thought I was hearing God. Well, grow. Or, as you do, you avoid some things. I heard the Spirit of God tell me, go to Mama's house. Well, it's nearly midnight. So I began to get dressed. We were already, you know, in our lounge clothes. I began to get dressed. I told Susan, we need to go see Mama. Now, she lives 30 minutes away, I guess. It's going to be midnight when we get there. It's about midnight now. I said to Susan, we got to go see Mama. She said, what for? And I said, I don't know. Well, Susan, trust me, because we've not had a lifestyle of a lot of weird things. So she trusts me. Prove all things, hold fast that which is good. We've proven some things, and I've developed and grown, and I know how to hear his voice. Now, years and years and years ago, I've made more mistakes. And one way you grow is by growing by your mistakes. If you don't face and admit your mistakes, you'll keep making them. Can somebody say amen? And so she trusts me. She said, what for? And I said, I don't know. But let's go. Well, she trusts that. She said, there's a reason why. We know. Now, I know he doesn't just do this on his own. There's a reason why. We get there. I was rehearsing to myself what I'm going to say, because she's going to ask, what are you here for? So I don't know what to say. So I'll just say, well, we were in your area, because when we get there, that'll be true. Well, I knocked on the door, and the first thing that happens is she pulls back that curtain at the window on the door, and turns the porch light on, pulls back that curtain, looks out to see who's there. Then she unlocks the door and opens the door, and she greets us and happy to see us. And she's got soft drinks all prepared. You know, she keeps drinks that she thinks I'm going to like, or any of her family, you know. My family likes this, so she'll stock up. But before, you know, she asked why I was here. Well, it's good to see you. What brings you out so late? Well, we were in your area and wanted to stop by. Would you like something to drink? And then she's bringing something out of the kitchen. We weren't there, I don't suppose it's 15 minutes, and her house caught fire. If we hadn't been there, I don't know what would have happened. It would have been a lot more damage, had some damage, because I had to go up in the attic and put the fire out. I smelled the smoke, saw the smoke in the kitchen, went up in the attic and saw the fire. The fire was in the attic. And some smoke, and I smelled it. Just a little bit of smoke in the kitchen, but there's already a fire. And she's asleep. So I got up in the attic, put out the fire, and she had some damage. I mean, you might have some damage. Well, God's a God of restoration. Said out loud, God is a God of restoration. Even if I have some damage, he's a restorer. But see, this could have cost her life. God can fix even more damage. God's more interested in lives than he is property anyway. But this could have cost her life. 15 minutes. We're there 15 minutes and our house caught on fire. Well, I heard a sound. And I've developed and made some mistakes over the years, and I've proven some things, held fast to that which is good, and you grow that way. Because you're going to make mistakes. Turn and tell your neighbor, I think he's talking to you. You're going to make some mistakes. We all will, and we all do. But as you face them and do what you can to correct them, acknowledge them, recognize them, don't despise the prophecy, but hold fast to that which is good. Prove it. Then you grow, and you more recognize the voice of the Lord. The voice. Hear the sound. Hear the call. Hear the sound. Gather round one and all. God wants to lead us by His Word, but by His Spirit. Can somebody say amen? I was at a traffic light. I was the first one. There was a car behind me, and the light turned green, and I heard words on the inside. Don't go yet. To me, it sounded just like that. I'm going to try to repeat it the way I heard it. The light turned green. Don't go yet. Well, that jarred me because I didn't expect to hear a voice on the inside. So I'm obeying that voice, but it also jarred me. So I stayed right there. If I had gone, I would have been broadsided by a speeding car that ran their red light. I would have been T-boned. What did I say? Broadside. All right, I would have been T-boned. Coming from my right would have hit the passenger side, and I was by myself, but that car was speeding and ran a red light. And if I had gone, I would have been right in the path of that car. And it was a little over a hill. I wouldn't have seen it in time. If I had gone, and you don't see the car yet, because it's coming up over a hill speeding, not a big hill, but enough to where I don't see it. If I had gone, I would have been T-boned by a speeding. I mean, not just a little speeding, but fast. Might have been 70 miles per hour in a 35 mile per hour zone. Don't go yet. I'm glad I heard the voice. I want to follow that voice. Stay right here 15 minutes. I want to recognize that and stay and avoid the tragedy. Now, sometimes you're in the storm and you walk on the water and you feel no alarm because you experience no harm. Other times, He wants us to avoid some things. Can somebody say amen? Amen.